graphing intervals and inequalities. It says, express each of the following intervals. Okay, the following in interval notation. Express each of the following in interval notation and graph. So look at it. Just look up here. What's the interval notation? There's the interval notation. So they are asking us to express these inequalities in the form of these ones. We should express them in interval notation. So let's take them. Let's take them. Look at this first one. Minus 2 is less than x is less than 5. Less than, right? Okay, this one. Less than. A less than x less than 5. Minus 2 less than x less than 5. So it means our A now represents the minus 2 and our B represents the 5, right? If you look here, it is an open interval. A, comma, B. So, solution. So the first one, we have minus 2 less than x less than 5. So they said we should write the interval notation and then we graph them. So the first one, interval notation. So the interval notation, since it is an open interval, just write this thing like this, parenthesis open and closes, where the minus 2, comma, where the 5. So that's what we saw up there. A, comma, B, parenthesis open, is an open interval. Then the graph. So to graph it, we just, this number, number 2, minus 2, and then 5. So you write minus 2 and 5, the smallest one on the left hand side. Since it is an open interval, we open it like this, parenthesis, and then we open it like this. So it means all these numbers between here, the solution has to do with all these numbers between here, but minus 2 and minus 5, they are not included. That's the first one. Let's move to the second one. Minus 3 is less than or equal to x, is less than or equal to 9. Now look there now. Less than or equal to closed interval. Less than or equal to x, less than or equal to a, less than or equal to x. X less than or equal to b. It's a closed interval, right? So it is by a bracket opens a comma b, bracket closes. So it closes at minus 3, it also closes at positive 9. So this is b, and the interval notation is just minus 3, comma, positive 9. This is the interval notation, minus 3, positive 9. To graph, we have minus 3, and then we have positive 9. The smallest number on the left hand side. Since it is closed, we use bracket. It's closed, we use bracket. So there is it. There is it. That's just for very, very simple. C. C says minus 1 less than x less than or equal to 5. So now you know that this thing, this is a graph, please, the graph. This is a graph. So the first one is the interval notation. So you just look here. This thing, this is open interval. When there is no line on this less than or equal to sign, is an open interval. So this thing opens at minus 1. It opens at minus 1. Then it closes at positive 5. It closes at positive 5. That's all. So to the graph. The graph now will just be you have minus 1 and positive 5. Now we're going to use another symbol, right? The cell, we can also use a dot and an open stop over the number. So it's just from all the way here, from this minus 1 all the way to minus 5, or minus 5 is not included. So let's move on to the next one. We have C. Okay. Okay, C has both of them, right? C has minus 1, less than X, less than equal to 5, and. So that's two of them. So let's graph it. And the next one says, I put it right here, and 2 is less than X, is also less than 6, right? So now, this one is open, it's open. So it's 2 comma 6, it opens at both ends. So to do the graph now, it's just simple, nothing is difficult. So we have, if we want to list some numbers, in fact, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and so forth. Okay, so this one will push it in front to 6, 7, right? So we graph the first one. This one says minus 1, comma 5. Minus 1, comma 5. So this is minus 1, and this is 5, right? So minus 1, comma 5. Now what we do is that, because we have two of them, so we can extend them up. So we just say this one minus 1 comma 5, this is minus 1. So I will put, say it opens at minus 1. I put this symbol for open interval on top. And then it closes at 5. I carry the disc. It leaves the line and then it closes at minus 5, at positive 5. That's the first one. Then the second one says, 2, positive 2. This is positive 2, right? This is positive 2. So it opens at positive 2. It opens at positive 2. And it also opens at positive 6. So this has to do with this whole thing up here. So I just paint it up so that you can see it. Opens at 6. So there's something like this. So from minus 1 all the way to 5, and then from positive 2 to positive 6. Now, what does this mean? This indicates that there is an intersection between the two intervals. So if you want to identify that intersection, see this, if we graph it like this, there is an intersection between those two intervals. Graph it like this, put it on the line, like this one. Okay, so let's say 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so forth. This is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Put it on the line. The first one is minus 1, minus 1. It's open, right? So I open at minus 1. It's on the line. Minus 1 is open. And then all the way it closes at 5. Where is 5? This is 5. It closes at 5. Right there. Closes at 5. Right? Then let's see the next one. The next one says it intersect. This interval intersect 2 comma 6. This is 2. It opens at 2. And it also opens at 6. So if someone asks me for the intersection, what is the intersection for this and this? Meaning all of those elements that are within this interval and also within this interval. So this interval, minus 1, comma 5. this interval comprises of minus, or let's say, 0. It comprises of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The next interval here comprises of 2 is not included now, so it's 3, 4, and 5. 6 also is not included. So see, what is the intersection? The intersection between this and this. You have 0, 0 is not here, 1, 1 is not here, 2, 2 is not here, 3 is here, 4 is here, 5 is here. So 3, 4, 5 is the intersection. So if you just look there, you see 3, 4, 5 is the intersection right here. This is the intersection right here. This is the intersection right here. Right there is the intersection. So if you are asked to find the intersection for this interval notation and this interval notation, if you are asked to find the intersection, that's the intersection. Right? But we're just asked to graph. To graph it. So there's the graph. So you see that one is passing through another one. Okay. The next one. On my ways, radius up. D says x is less than or equal to minus 5. So we must first write the interval notation. What is the interval notation? X, what are those number on the number line that are less than, they say x is less than minus 5. So it means all those numbers that are less than minus 5, they are within the negative direction. Just look up here. Unbounded interval. Unbounded interval. X is less than or equal to a. And what is the notation for a? Negative infinitive? A, negative infinitive A. So this one now should be negative infinitive A. What is our A? Our A is our minus 5. It closes at A and it opens at infinity. So we graph the two, it's a graph. So we draw our graph like this. Then we just write 5, negative 5. So all of those numbers, they are on the left of 5. This side. It opens, that's when you see us writing it using the bracket. So it's all of these numbers are the set of solution. That's a graph. The next one, x is greater than or equal to 5. X is greater than or equal to 5. X greater than or equal to 5. So E says x is greater than or equal to 5. Now look there now, look up there. X is less than or equal to some b. X is greater than or equal to b. X is greater than b. So if x is greater than b, what are those numbers that are greater than b? Those numbers that are greater than b, they are in the positive direction. So you see positive infinity from b all the way to positive infinity. So what is b? B is 5. So the interval notation here now will just be from 5. Now it closes at 5 where it is equal to, greater than or equal to, and all the way to positive infinity. So the graph now will be this is 5, and in this direction, all these numbers that are within the direction, they are part of the solution of inequality. All those numbers are part of the solution. This is 5. And the last one says minus 3 less than x less than or equal to 8. So it opens at the interval notation, it opens at minus 3,
And it closes at 8. 8. It closes. I just thought. 4 p.m. and close. So to do the graph now, draw a line like this and indicate minus 3, comma, and 8. So it opens at minus 3, it opens right there. And it closes at 8. So this is to say, what if you were asked to list all of the elements of this set? All of the elements of this set include minus 3 is not there. From there you go it down. It's minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Because 3 is not included, but 8 is included because of this closed interval. That's how you list, if you were asked to list the elements of this set. These are the elements of this interval notation, minus 3, comma, positive 8. Okay. So, thanks for watching.